Good afternoon, everyone. Here's Ford Mustang 98 guy, and today let's take an in-depth look at this 2011 Mazda CX-7. Today I'm going to give you all a full in-depth walk around of the CX-7. I'm going to start it up. I'm also going to show you the engine. I'm also going to show you all the interior and the exterior of the SUV. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and start it up, let it run. This one here is for sale at Maple Mazda. This one also has smart key access. Make sure you have the key in your pocket. You see it's unlocked. Push the button to lock it. Then after waiting a second, push the button again, it automatically unlocks the car. It's a white exterior with tan leather interior. White on the outside, tan on the inside. Keyless start. So all you gotta do is just twist this knob. Yeah. This camera likes to go out of focus sometimes. This one has 52,000 kilometers on it. And it fires right up. Got a 3-spoke leather wrapped steering wheel. Extremely tight power steering. You got a 5-speed automatic transmission right there. Manual shift mode right there. You also have a backup camera right there. Mark your parking brakes down there.
Vince to the sales office, please, Vince.
It's on, that's off. So, flip on the automatic headlights, fog lights, and turn on the hazards. And we'll roll down the window and check out the outside. Not a bad little SUV. Actually, the CX-5 is a smaller one, or the CX-3 is the smallest one out of all of them. Standard Bridgestone tires.
Paul Joseph, 101, please call 101.
Their brake light up top.
Exhaust.
Pop the hood. Coming up to the hood, you have, I believe it's 2.5 or 2.0. 2.3 turbo 4-cylinder,
just like that speed 3.
Just like the speed 3, it's the same engine. Nice. Same engine from the speed 3. Now I'll do a review on the inside now. Power door locks, power windows, power mirrors, no lock, storage, full power seats, manually tilting steering wheel, and we'll give this one a couple revs. Yeah, it's getting pretty chilly out here, a little bit windy. Hear a bit of the turbo whine. Not bad. I don't want to use my zoom too much. So, climate control. Shows up there too, along with your fan speed, different modes, front defrost, and your temperature is off to this side. Rear defrost, right there. Air conditioning and recirculation. And it all shows up there. Different modes, pretty nifty. Down here, power outlet, pretty nifty. Put a little bit of storage there if you want. Cup holders along with your heated seats for the driver and passenger. And you got some storage in there. Bose audio system with CD player. We also have Sirius satellite radio.
Chum FM.
Not bad. Sounds great. Automatic dimming rearview mirror. You have mirror vanity light. Map lights. You also have a power sliding sunroof. It's a little dirty. Over here, you have your tachometer, speedometer, gas gauge, temperature, and your gear selector would be right here. M mode. Your headlights, fog lights, turn signals are one stock. And your wipers are off to this side. Low speed and high speed right there. Pretty nifty. Cruise control, your driver information system. What the hell? It shows right there, I don't understand. Please, come on, I'm running out of power. Voice command. Help.
You can make calls by saying call, dial, or redial. Say phone book to manage the...
Cancel. It's pretty nifty. Radio controls, cruise control here. All control by there. Turn it on, turn it off. Just like that. For some reason, there's your average economy right there. I can't scroll through it for some reason. And this changes the station. All controlled by there, but this for here. This is your average economy. Doesn't show anything else. And your trip computer would be right there. And your gauge brightness. You push it in, I guess you can tell the dim. Nifty. Okay, let's go ahead and put the window back down and we'll go ahead and check out the back seat. Here's your fuse box. Let's go ahead and step inside the back. Oh, that's pretty comfortable back here. Ocean handles with coat hooks. Same off to that side. And yep, cup holders. A bit of storage in there. Pretty nifty. Pretty nifty SUV. That light works. It's not a bad SUV. It'd be great for someone to buy. The trunk. Rear hatch. same deal on this side. It smells nice on the inside though. Power door locks, storage in there. Same deal, power seats as well for the passenger side. Just gonna step on in for a second. Glove box, pretty nifty. All right, so I guess that's pretty much about it. Shut this one off and that's it. Let's shut her down. Hope you guys enjoyed the full in-depth walk around of the 2011 Mazda CX-7. Should stay tuned next time. There's a lot more that came from. Thanks for watching and goodbye.